Sorry for the delay, but sometimes it's okay to take a break and mind your own business.
So let's talk about Raz B versus his uncle slash cousin, Chris Stokes. Wait, what? The F is an uncle cousin. Y'all know when your mom or dad's first cousin, who, don't argue me, but to me should be considered your second aunt or uncle, but most will call them cousins too. I don't know how that worked, but whatever, that's his older cousin by 20 years, but really, that's not the point here. Look, a lot of you were just kids when this occurred and are not really up on it, so here's a little refresher, especially since Raz B himself literally just resurfaced this topic. And child, honey, it's too much, so get ready. Long story short, over a decade ago, Raz B accused Chris Stokes and Marcus Houston of doing you-know-what to him. Listing him. Get my drift? And initially, it was just Chris Stokes, then he changed it to also being Marcus Houston too, and then he said that Chris did it to all of the members of B2K, and then he said that he can't speak for the rest of them, but he knows for a fact that it happened to him, and then he also claimed that Chris made him and Jay Boog do some things together, and then he said that he does not know why Fizz is making him out to be crazy instead of backing him up, when according to him, Fizz was the first one to take it up the backside.
Fizz was the first person to take it in his and he want to make it seem like I'm crazy, like I did something to him.
Yeah, who all, you know, reached out to check on our brother, you know, in his time and to make sure that he was okay.
Yeah, and we definitely don't always agree on everything, but one thing that we do agree on is the love that we have for our fans and supporters around the whole globe, baby. Right. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? The Millennium Tour is not going anywhere.
Me and Boo was in a room together. Chris Stokes put us in a room together and made us do stuff together.
Girl. Then Raz B's older brother Ricky confirmed that yeah, their cousin Chris really did that to Raz. Matter of fact, he did it to both of them, and that he should have protected his little brother.
Chris, you got something coming, and guess what? All my family on my mom's side, guess what? You know the truth, y'all. Y'all sweep that shit under the rug and keep protecting Chris all you want.
Marcus, when I see you, I'm punching you out, man. Chris, when I see you, I'm punching you out, nigga. From cousin to cousin, I'm punching you out. Believe that. Y'all nigga keep up with my brother, my nigga. I promise you this ain't a threat, it's a promise. I will murder you. Nigga can go to jail for the rest of my life, okay? Raz ain't crazy, I'm crazy.
But honestly, years later, Ricky also spreaded a story that his little brother Raz B was in a coma in China after being hit by a bottle, which Raz's own publicist put out there and claims that his family made her do. Weird, just weird. So folks really don't trust their fickle word. And at the time, Chris Stokes' career was basically hanging by a string. His reputation was completely ruined. His pockets started to hurt. So he issued the following statement. The accusations that DeMario Raz B. Torton and Ricardo Torton have made are vehemently false and hold no merit. I have recently stopped financially supporting both individuals along with assisting them with their criminal and legal matters, which leads me to believe that they are resentful and looking to benefit financially from this.
Yeah, I got a police record. It is what it is. Because guess what? He ain't did shit for the family and he ain't doing shit for you.
My family is my first priority and the reason why I have been so supportive of them. In bringing these false claims, they have not only slandered me, they have also put me in the position to ensure that the truth is known and I will take all legal routes to protect myself, my family, and my four kids. It's also quite ironic that these statements were made only 2 weeks after they were denied admittance by a venue for an event I hosted in Beverly Hills. So then suddenly, Raz B retracted all of his statements and said that none of it is true, and he issued an apology, which at the time, Stokes was happy about, and said that he knew that his fam would come through and tell the truth.
You're not gonna sweep anything under the rug. I was molested by Chris Stokes and Mark Houston, and that's the truth, period.
My name is DeMario Thornton, publicly known as Raz B of B2K. I just want to say that those allegations are not true with Chris Stokes and Marcus Houston. And I apologize for any hurt that this may cause publicly, financially.
Interesting. Raz B was being depicted as a lunatic who made stuff up that didn't happen in his head. And he also admitted to be suffering from mental health issues. So keep that in mind. But child, it was a whole mess. And now he's back to saying it's all true and that he's ready to talk and wants Lifetime to holler at him for surviving Chris Stokes. Ooh.
I don't feel safe because I feel like Chris Stokes is around. So guess what? I'm off the tour. Amari, if you come talk to me and you want me to do this tour, I'll do this tour, but I'm officially off the tour. Okay? Oh, and guess what? I guess we're about to shoot the new Surviving Chris Stokes movie, right? So, yo, Ricky Rowe, call Lifetime, because I'm ready to talk.
Oh, Lord. Look, I personally don't put anything past anybody on this earth. So if that really happened, then Chris is really a sick man. But based on Raz's story changing a million times, who knows what's really true? But I do know something for a fact. I personally know someone who has dealt with Chris Stokes as far as music goes, because he was trying to sign them amidst these allegations, and then that turned out to be some bullshit, okay? He basically super played with her career, which is completely messed up. But then again, he clearly was not in his right mind, you know, being faced with what his cousin accused him of, so he was fake trying to sign artists, and that's facts.
You know how many artists Chris Stokes signed and never came out? The only reason why they would do something for you is because they want to honor their contract.
And that's facts. Look, if y'all want this person to speak on her personal experiences with him, I can get her to talk. But overall, what do y'all think about this Raz B and Chris Stokes mess resurfacing?
Like, I've been protecting people for a long time. I have nothing to lose. I have nothing to fear. And it's just, it's tacky. And I don't give a about B2K. B2K. You know what I'm saying? I am B2K. And if they're going to get right, you're going to have to come clean.
Leave your thoughts below. And while you're at it, be sure to head over to patsez.com. That's PATSEZ.com to shop for the latest women's outerwear. Shoot, I literally just ordered my very fashionable coat from them and just had to come share the site with y'all so y'all could be fly too, okay? So make sure you go check it out. You won't be disappointed, I promise. Patsez.com. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to this channel for more. PetsyBlog.com signing off.